why it's happening to me, trying to figure out why it's happening for me, and to understand what his will is for all of this happening, so that I can keep a roof over me and my daughter's head, and to do his will. So instead of me worrying, I want to trust God and hopefully, you know, figure out what to do next.
I believe God's going to do that. What kind of business do you have?
I've been a hairstylist for 19 years, but my business hasn't been doing so well over the last couple of years.
Do you have a mall, a hair salon online?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Well, we're going to bless that because you sell hair?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to ask the Holy Spirit to begin to multiply those sales. And as he does, he's going to fulfill everything that you have need of. David said, I was young and now I'm old. I have not sowed a seed to righteous forsaken, neither baking bread. God has promised to bless you. And as we just pray, we're going to pray for you right now in the name of Jesus. And God is going to meet those needs in your life. And you're going to be greatly encouraged as a move of God begin to sweep over your finances and to bless your housing, to keep you in a good, safely place and pay your car. God, to bless you now, daughter, in the name of Jesus, we decree for you to take care of your five-year-old and that she grows in the knowledge and the grace of God because of your faithfulness to the Almighty. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you so much. God bless you.
Bless you. We give him praise. Just pray. Pick up the phone and dial. Area code 313-838-1035. Off the air. 313-279-0558. Just pray. In Jesus' name, we'll take our next caller. Sharon from Southfield. Good morning, Sharon.
Good morning. You are just so wonderful. I thank God for all you do. And I would like to have prayer for my friend who had a tooth removed, and the dentist said she could not go to sleep all night. I'm concerned about her. And also, regarding the devil, are we allowed to say that we want the devil to die or to leave this world? Because that's what I want to say. And also, I would like prayer for me and for my friend I just mentioned, and also for Angela. Angela needs $100 or she's going to lose her place this Friday. So if there's anybody out there who knows of a place that can either loan or help her in some way, otherwise she's very worried about it. And so I ask prayer for her and for all of us in this whole world. We also need prayer for this country, and our world has a lot of problems. So from A to Z, and thank you so much.
Amen. We just moved into a situation where the country is in big trouble. United States has no real leader now. The leadership has died. And what's going on, the enemy is waiting to attack our country. And I've been trying to tell people, and that's 2 Chronicles 7:14, if my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and will heal their land. And then he went on in verse 15, now my eyes shall be open and my ears attend unto the prayer that is made in this place. Now, I give God the praise because God says, if my people, who are they? You're one of them, daughter. But there's multitudes of others that's running from God and they're soliciting themselves in the love and affairs of this world. Everything here is temple. The God we serve is eternal. The eternal weight of glory is about to be fulfilled because God's will is being carried out now. In Jesus' name, I'm asking for the Holy Spirit to begin to minister and do minister life and life more abundantly. In Jesus' name. And I'm asking for God to bless you, your friend, God, to heal that person. And the $100 is coming now. In Jesus' name.
And I pray for you and for Gloria and for all of us.
Thank you. And we give God the praise for that right now. In Jesus' name, amen. We'll take the call from Redford.
Good morning, Bishop Tate.
Good morning.
Amen. God bless you. And I'm calling for prayer for my son this morning. He went to the doctor yesterday and they said he had walking pneumonia. I'm asking the Lord to touch his body, deliver him, and also give him, he needs an A to Z prayer. He needs the Lord to touch his life. He needs the Lord to heal his body. He needs just an overhaul in Jesus' name.
God, to heal your son right now with that overhaul of the Holy Ghost.
Yes,
and the Spirit of God to quicken him, to draw him.
Yes.
By the power of Jesus Christ, we decree it now.
Decree it.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you, Bishop. Thank you.
And God bless you. Amen. Paul, good morning. Good morning, Paul.
God bless you, Bishop. Amen. Got me praying in tongues over here. Amen. Because many, amen, are at home, and they got these different conditions, but they go to their doctor's appointment. Even like my sister just took her brother, her son was walking pneumonia. Now, the deliverance is in the house of God. When Sunday come, tell him you're going to the doctor. Take him to the house of God. Amen. And we got to get up. Amen. And we're going to these doctor's appointments, but nobody has been to the house of God ever since Bishop has moved over there, and God has moved so immaculately with what we're doing. But Bishop, I'm going to say this. Amen. No man has seen God at any time, but we say we love God. Half the broadcast listeners have never seen Pastor Kate. How can you say you love God whom you have not seen? And if we see how much we love Pastor Tate, whom we have not seen, and there's a place you can go Wednesday, Friday, distributor of food, Saturday, Sunday. Let's be real here, saints, and people of God who's making their mind up whether they want to be on the Lord's side. Okay, I'll make this real sharp, Bishop. Amen, because I could not help but call tonight. Because the Lord have you on fire. Amen. You're giving the blessed word of God. And we eating it all up. And we're not being doers of the word. They won't even come to the house of God. Now, this anniversary, I'm proclaiming that many of us now, we're going to be at the house of God on Sunday. This coming Sunday. We're going to see Bishop. We're going to bless Bishop when we come. In the name of Jesus. All right, Bishop. Pretty much for me, because the Lord is taking me to another level. I'm trying to get this house together for adult foster care. I got another house, and all of me roofs. I don't have a certain amount of money. People sitting in my homes don't have no money. Pray much for Elder and his wife, Bishop.
Right now.
Thank you, Jesus.
They better go get a paper route. They better
something,
go get
cut
something.
Grass, something.
Because God.
And guess what?
Ain't
going
to sit
that to
back and just let you. Yeah,
I'm looking for many listeners
to do something so that God can get the glory.
Amen.
I'm asking for God to bless you with people around you that mean something to you, that his spirit can multiply, not only in your life, in their life too.
Mm.
In Jesus' name, we thank God for that. Just pray.
Thank you, Bishop.
In Jesus' name, and God to bless you with that new roof and everything that you need.
Amen. Thank you, Bishop. Amen. Three houses. One of them, a man moved in it. I went over there. He's working on my house. I said, well, this guy putting the roof. I'm like, sure, what you going to do? I said, nothing. If he that stupid, he would bring a thing by my house, asking to buy this particular house, and I have a response to it. They thought I was in jail. They said, I went to court yesterday on that. This man standing here, he done put all his work in my house, Bishop. He got a deed and everything. A quick claim deed. He probably got this house for $1,000 in the land bank. Please, please, please. I bought that house for hood. Lord gave me the house for hood in 83, Bishop. And the house went up to $100-some thousand. I'm not going to sell the house. Now it went down to almost, what, $12,000? So pray for much, Bishop. But that devil, he know my name. Amen. So
did you get your house back?
Huh? Oh, no, we're in the process now. He got a deed. I got a deed. The girl had to know. And Mr. Jones came over yesterday, and he was harassing me and da-da-da. And look, her boyfriend told me, get out of the driveway. No, get out of the driveway. He said, you got to be in court tomorrow. I said, court for what? I'm not going to court for nothing. I said, I'm over because of the blight next door a lot. He said, well, da-da-da-da-da. I said, look, man. He said, what is your name? Are you Paul Jones? I said, no, I'm not Paul Jones. I said, my name is Mr. H. Ghost. He said, well, Mr. Ghost, he said, you can leave. Get out of my driveway. And, Bishop, I rode out of my driveway and met that butts in court this morning.
And that's what so Ted tied up, tell the judge said she's a female. She said, look, y'all gonna take this to another court. Cause it's deeper than that. All my antique cars, I told her, they took a 50. Okay, bitch, I'm not going to do this on air. Okay, God bless you, bitch. I'll see you in one of these
classes. Bye-bye. Amen. We'll take our next call. Uh-huh. Trudy from Detroit.
Hi.
Hi, Trudy.
Can you hear me? Yeah. How are you?
I'm blessed and favored, Trudy.
Yes. I need some prayer, Pastor Tate. There's a few things I want to do, but I will talk to somebody, Gloria, off the ear. But I need a financial blessing. And Pastor Tate, I've been having problems with my knees, you know. Got that arthritis in my knees, and it's kind of hard for me to walk. But also, I just got a little small T-shirt website started, and I need some prayer for that, you know, that I can prosper with that.
God to bless right now that you'll be able to prosper with that. By his grace and mercy, God's spirit to bless and to do minister like never before.
Yes,
and God to prosper that T-shirt ministry and that financial blessing that you need now.
Yes,
in Jesus' name we pray it to be so. Amen.
Okay, and Pastor Tate, God bless you and your family, and God bless us all. I want to ask you for the off-the-ear number, too, if it's all right with you.
313-279-0558.
All right. Will I be able to contact Sister Gloria?
You may run into her now. Call.
Okay, then. Thank you, sir, and God bless you.
Okay. Bless you. Nick from Warren. Bless you.
Hey, Pastor Tate.
Hey.
Pray for me, Pastor Tate. I'm a backslider. I want to come back to the Lord. I want to be saved. And
right now, Nick, God is married to the backslider like he's married to you.